Hi, this is Anne with Graphic Design How To, and in this video, I'm going to show you how to enable Generative Fill in Adobe Photoshop. And this is if it's grayed out, or you just can't see it, or some other problem is happening. All right, let's get started. Now, if you're not sure what Generative Fill is in Adobe Photoshop, it's basically a way to realistically add, change, or remove things from photos, just like you're seeing right up here on your screen. And to see more about it, head to this video right at the top of your screen, and you can learn all about how to use it. It's pretty awesome. But if it's not available for you, here are a few things that you can try. Now, if you can see Generative Fill, but you can't select it, it's grayed out. Just jump to this timestamp in this video where I show you a few ways to fix that. First things first, if you can't see Generative Fill at all, head to your Creative Cloud app. You'll want to log into your Creative Cloud desktop app and then come over here on the left side to Beta Apps. You'll see Photoshop Beta here. So go ahead and install here. If you see an update here, go ahead and install that update too. And once you've done that, you can open the Photoshop Beta app. You'll need to open a file. You'll also have to have something selected. You can select something with your marquee tool like this, but I usually use my lasso tool, which is this first one right here. Then you can just draw around part of your image. And then come up here to Edit, Generative Fill. This will give you either this prompt or you'll have a long, skinny contextual taskbar right here. And I'm going to type in dressy blue blouse and generate. And then you can scroll through the three options right here on this bar. Now, if you're not seeing the bar, you can come up here to Window, Contextual Taskbar right down here at the bottom. Okay, those are very dressy. So first, you have to be on this new Photoshop beta right here, and you have to have something in your image selected. You can also start a new image by going to File, New. Make sure it is RGB and 8-bit or 16-bit. You'll still have to have something selected here. Then you should be able to see Generative Fill right here. Now, if your options are grayed out despite doing these first steps, make sure your document is either an RGB 8-bit or an RGB 16-bit document. And to check that, you can come up here to Image, Mode, and here's RGB, so it has to be under RGB, and it also has to be one of these two. If you have RGB 32, it will not work. If you're still coming up here to Edit, and it's still grayed out right here, it's time to head over to Behance, even if you don't use Behance. So go back to your Creative Cloud app, and scroll down to Behance right over here in the lower left corner. You'll be taken to a screen like this, where it's one of your birth month and year. You'll need to fill this out to be able to use Generative Fill. And by the way, you do have to be over 18. Now, once you've shared your information with Behance, quit the Photoshop beta and relaunch it. Now Generative Fill should be enabled. Now, if you've tried these things and you still can't use it, here are some reasons why. You may have a team or enterprise license for your account. It's possible that the ability for you personally to download the beta apps has not been enabled. So in that case, you'll need to contact the admin for that team or enterprise license and check if they can enable the beta apps download for you. I'm not seeing the latest updates in the Photoshop beta app. Now, if you're here in Creative Cloud and you're not seeing an update right here, you might need to go up here on the left to Updates and then check for updates right here. You'll want to update to build M.2196 or later. Another thing that might be wrong is you may not have a Photoshop license if you've only purchased like a single app license for Illustrator, for example. Generative Fill is only going to be available to Photoshop users. For users under 18, Generative Fill is visible, but it'll be grayed out or disabled. If you live in China, unfortunately, Generative Fill is not available for you at this time. If you're still not seeing Generative Fill, try signing out and signing back into your Creative Cloud desktop and Photoshop beta apps. If you sign in using social sign-in like Apple, Google, or Facebook, make sure that your date of birth in those accounts is set to public instead of private. And finally, Generative Fill is not available on mobile at the moment. It's desktop only, but hopefully that'll change soon. All right, I hope this video has been helpful for you. If you liked it and you want to see more videos like this, just hit the subscribe button and the little bell next to it, and you'll be notified every time a new video comes out. All right, I'll see you in the next video. Thank you.